Hi. We are living in an exciting era where innovation and technology has the potential to do the unimaginable. And it becomes even more unimaginable when it breaks down the gaps between disability and ability. 15% of the world population, in number, 1 billion people around the world live with disabilities, which makes people with disabilities the largest minority in the world. And they are not living in a different planet. They may be part of our families, friends, or colleagues. Today, I'm going to tell you how people with a speech disability will have a way to better communicate. I was 7 years old when my sister Amal was born. I was too young to see the challenges that my family was facing on a daily basis. But I could see that Amal couldn't crawl or eat or talk like any other baby in her age. But with time, we adjusted to raise a baby with cerebral palsy, while understanding her special communication patterns and needs. 9 years later, my family was blessed to have another baby, Ahmed. Ahmed decided to grow up exactly like his sister Amal, being so smart, so sharp, curious about everything around him, but also him, decided to invent his special communication patterns to communicate with us. And for the other people that couldn't understand him, we had to translate. Amal and Ahmed say num when they are hungry. And they say ah to call the name of Noura, my sister. And when they want to call my name, they say Abia. In case they want to go to the bathroom, they say kh. We understand most of their special communication patterns, but it's only us, the closed circle. And this is the case for most of the people who have an unclear voice. One of these people is Orit. Orit is a 34-year-old woman with cerebral palsy. She's living an independent life. She can drive her car, goes to the gym, and do a lot of things. However, when it comes to communicating using her voice, sometimes becoming harder than going to the gym, and more frustrating, because she found herself repeating the same word again and again in order to be understood. We asked Orit to say a few words in English. And let's listen to her together and see if you can understand what she's trying to say.
Now I can start speaking freely.
I don't know how many of you could understand from the first time, but let's listen to her again and really focused and trying to understand what she's trying to say.
Now I can start speaking freely.
Try to memorize what she just had said, and we will get to that later. With my siblings and Reed and people that I got to know, I had the chance to see a world full of challenges, a world of special people with needs. And this allowed me to examine the existing technology in search for an answer for what my siblings were seeking. Unfortunately, current state-of-the-art assistive technology, including speech recognition applications, could not provide an answer. Since then, all the assistive technology has completely bypassed the voice, opting to use other modes of communication. When replacing the voice with symbols and images, or movements of the body in the head or in the eyes. And this brings me to the other lightweight alternative that does use the voice, which is speech recognition applications. And this technology works in two approaches. The first approach attempts to discover which word has been said. And the second approach relies on the phonemes. Phonemes are all the sounds that we produce from our mouth and nose. Both approaches rely on statistical models from a large database of standard speech. But once the speech is not standard, and when I say not standard, I mean, it's enough to have an accent, like most of us here. This will not work. My colleagues and I developed a new approach of assistive technology that does use the person's own voice and also can understand the non-standard speech patterns, with the mission to give people with a speech disability their voice back. So, whose life is going to change? People with cerebral palsy, people with Parkinson, myasthenia gravis, and so many neurologic disorders, people that born with hearing disabilities, or people that suddenly in the middle of their life had a stroke and changed all their lives, but not only them. Not only the people that has difficulty expressing themselves, but everyone that interacts with them on a daily basis. What will make it easier for them to be socially included? Because every one of us wants to be socially included. And now, you may be asking yourself, how does it work? And how the current speech recognition technology couldn't do the same? Because our technology works in a different way. So, each person has to go through two phases. The first phase, called the calibration phase, where the person has to teach the device and the application his own patterns by entering the patterns and building his own dictionary. This phase usually happens with the person that understands him the most. Together, they will build the dictionary. It generally takes only 1 to 3 hours. It depends on the user's capability of speaking. After building the dictionary, we move to the second phase, which is the recognition phase. The application will be able to recognize the unintelligible speech patterns from the dictionary that already built and translate it into a clear voice in real time. Our approach is a user-dependent and language-independent, which means it can work in any language in the world, even the invented ones. And the key word here is pattern matching. Once the person builds his own dictionary and says a word that already exists there, there will be a pattern matching between what he says and what already exists. But here we found a problem. We found that people with a speech disability pronounce different words in similar way. And the challenge was to differentiate between them. So we created a technology called adaptive framing. Adaptive framing technology can be adapted to the width of the event in the pattern. As you can see in the existing technology, you can see the L and the A in the same frame. But in our new technology, you can see that the L and the A are in different frames, which increase the accuracy of the pattern matching. And this makes our pattern matching so much better. I suppose that you still remember it, right? Let's listen to here again now, but this time using Talkit.
Now I can.
Now I can.
Start.
Start.
Speaking freely.
Speaking freely.
Talkit is only one step towards bridging the gap between disability and ability by letting people express their potential. And the more we challenge our minds, more gaps will be collapsed to let us all have a normal life. Thank you.